Okay, this is the start of my training video on how to move a computer from one location to another. We're going to use, as a demonstration subject, we're going to use Katie's computer, and we're just going to move it from there to over at this empty cubicle. And Carmen's brother is here. He's going to help me out. So, it's already recording. So just kind of, you know, pointed at what I'm doing. For starters... come underneath. The computer should already be shut off. Let's see. Looks like in this case it's not. So we're gonna make sure that it's shut down. And as soon as this is done shutting down, we can start unplugging things underneath, like the space heater, which these are not going to go with us to the new office, or if they do, they're not going to be used. I recommend you have a flashlight, some small hand tools, pliers, Leatherman, anything like that. So, start by getting out things that you're not going to use. Get that out of the way. Alright, now the computer is done shutting off, so you'd want to shut off the UPS underneath. We've got a couple different models of UPS. This one's a little bit more tricky one. The big CyberPower ones, you just press the button for a second. These sometimes... let's try this again. Doesn't want to shut off, we can just unplug it and then silence the alarm. Some of these actually don't turn off. They're all failing on us. All right. Let's start unplugging the computer. Looks like she's got something else plugged in here as well. Cell phone charger or a headset. No dead mice under her desk. Lorenzo, I'm looking at you. So. Everything is unplugged. Now we can unplug the UPS. Okay, and it turned itself off. Good. Get that out. And we'll probably want to put a piece of blue tape across the top of each of these things to mark who they belong to, unless we're putting them directly in people's cars, which is the plan. So basically, as we unhook everything and get it bundled up, we should be loading it into the person's car of whoever the workstation belongs to. Like in this case, we'd load everything into Katie's car. So here's a good reason why you might want to have a knife or pliers. It's just to get any zip ties out. Is that showing up okay? Are you able to see on the screen what it is? Okay. I know it's kind of dark under here. So it looks like hers is bundled up pretty well with all these wire ties holding everything in place. Maybe I should have done one on somebody that didn't have a headset and so much extra stuff, but that's alright, I'm already started now. And she's also got some split loom already under here, so you can just pull all that off. And this, we'll most likely be using that at the new office too, so make sure that goes along with the rest of her stuff. So just keep looking under here, any twist ties, wire ties, zip ties, anything else that's holding any of these wires in place is going to need to be disconnected. And actually, this one is going to her light. The desk light, so we can leave that one. Everything else for the computer. And she's got her two network jacks under here. Just disconnect those. And it looks like we got pretty much everything unhooked under here. So let's go up top and see what we got. Hopefully by the time you guys are actually doing this, users will have their desks pretty much cleaned off of any supplies, staplers, tape, all this kind of stuff. You know, photographs, whatnot. So, pull the computer out a little ways. So you can get to the wiring at the back of it. Why don't you bring the camera up and just get a shot of how that wiring is run currently. With everything coming up from behind the desk and plugged right into the computer and then held together with that rubber band. There you go. So, let's do the monitors next. Looks like she's got some cords wrapped around those. Cell phone charger, camera cord, whatever this was. The monitors, you can generally lay them flat on their face. You know, try not to leave it anywhere where the face, where the surface of the screen is actually going to come in contact with anything. But it's okay to lean them like this. And then just unplug the cables, pull them through. Most monitors are going to have these, these passageways through it where, you know, to help route the cables. And it looks like on hers, one of the monitors is hooked up with a DisplayPort cable. Tough on these little cubicles because there's not as much space. And the other monitor is hooked up with a DVI cable. So this is why we want to make sure that the correct cables go with the correct users, because not everybody's monitors hook up the same way. So you want to make sure to include the correct cables. And also if there's a USB cable going to the monitor, that's generally plugs in so that the users can use these USB ports that are on the sides of some of these monitors. Now this one is free. Let me show you one other thing. Pretty much all of our monitors have a button to remove the stand. You can just press that button and then lift up the stand. And depending on how you're packing them in the cars, this can sometimes make things a lot easier. You know, if you're gonna wrap it, slide it into a box, lay it flat on a back seat or whatnot, it's a lot easier to store it, you know, once you've got it like this, as opposed to trying to store it with that stand attached. So that's just something that, you know, as you're packing these things into the cars, to be aware of. And then to put it back on, these two little slides right in there, clicks, and then it's back on there. So that's real easy. And then, in any case, you wouldn't want to wrap this or lay it flat on her back seat or however it's going to be transported over there. Now, in this case, I'm not going far, so we're just going to set it right over here. Just pretend that it was put in the back of a car and whatnot. Now back over here, we need to free up these cables from the back of her workstation. Make sure she doesn't have a tack hasp. We don't want to lose those or damage those in the process of moving, at least not while we're still using tack. But on the back of the machine, the power cord, USB cords, network cord, another USB cord, the DisplayPort cable, and the DVI cable. These thumb screws, usually you can just twist them and they'll come out. Sometimes you might need to put a pair of pliers on them if they get stuck, or you can also turn them with a flat blade screwdriver, just stick it in that slot and give it a little twist, and it'll usually come loose enough that you can get it with your fingers. So now this computer is free. What you'd want to do now is take it outside. Unless you want to breathe in a whole lot of dust, but take it outside. Pretty much all these computers open the same way. You just slide that back and then the side starts to pop open. And I don't know if you can see it on that camera, but there's dust falling inside of this when I pulled that side off. And but take it outside, get some compressed air. We're gonna have a bunch of cans of compressed air and give it a good blow it out from the inside. You'd blow it out that way, blow it out that way. Like you can see, these computers are full of dust. And that's one thing we don't want to take with us to the new office is a bunch of dust. Wow. Yeah. And that's why you do this outside with compressed air. Put the side back on. It's real easy. Same way as it came off. Line up these two little pieces here. Is that showing up okay on the camera? You just line up the side panel. And then snap it right back into place. Pretty much everybody's computer is going to open that same way. And do another check, make sure there's nothing plugged in. And then this computer would be ready to go. You transport it over to the new office, you know, carry it securely, you know, don't stack it on top of anything. Once you get it into the person's car, if they've got a blanket or a pillow or anything like that, buckle it in, you know, set it on the passenger seat and throw a seatbelt around it. That's now over at the new office. Amazing how fast that works. And we got all these cables still. So you could undo these rubber bands. It looks like there's quite a few around here, like they've been wrapped a few times. So I'm just gonna slice them. Cutting out to avoid jabbing into any of the cables. And you can see these rubber bands were pretty deteriorated anyways. So it pretty much just fell apart once I started slicing it. And what did I do with her trash can? There we go, good enough. So now, since these cables are going underneath the desk, I just push everything down. I'm making a couple of assumptions at this point that the cubicle work surfaces that we're purchasing for the new office are going to have holes in a similar location to our current cubicles, you know, in which case, you know, they should have a hole here and then a couple holes along the sides to allow you to run cables. Now, obviously, if that's not the case, we'll have to plan something different, but I think these things are pretty much all made the same, that they all have some holes to run cables. Down. Now, looks like the only cable that we have to pull back up, typically the keyboard you'd also have to pull back up, but I know Katie replaced her keyboard not too long ago and it didn't get routed quite correctly, so in this case the keyboard cord is not going down through the hole, but just the mouse cord is, and you kind of want to give that a little tug. Should be free, since we already disconnected everything underneath. Pull that through. Same thing with this monitor, you know, maybe blow with a little compressed air, knock some of the dust off of it. If you need to disconnect it, just push that button and take the screen off. You can even do it right when it's sitting up like that, but that makes it a little more tricky. Pack it in her car. She's gonna drive it to the new office. Vroom vroom, should I make some car noises as we're going from here to there? Now, last few things, still some accessories over here. Don't want to forget her keyboard. Some people get pretty particular about their keyboards, so you can blow that out with compressed air too. Maybe turn it upside down, shake out the staples, any other junk that might be in there, food crumbs, whatever. And I usually just wrap the keyboard cord around this narrow part of the keyboard a few times. Maybe tuck it under there. Put a piece of tape, piece of blue tape with the person's name on it if you need to identify who it belongs to. Keyboard over at the new office. Let's not forget our UPS. But is already, it's already off because it's been unplugged underneath. So you unplug the network cable. We can go ahead and push that down. The power cables on these are a little tricky because they're going through this little clip that holds them in place, and you can see a lot of these power cables have been damaged over the years. It's a little chewed up, so it's got some electrical tape around there. The good thing is, over at the new office, we're using power over Ethernet, so all of these power cables will go away. And you can actually, as you're transporting them over there, just throw all the phone power cables, throw them in my office, and I'll sort them out. Phone. Hopefully she'll have a box, because she does have a few accessories here with her phone. AC adapter for the headset. She will still need that, but like I said, you won't need the AC adapter for the phone itself. So now this phone is ready to go. You can put that in a box, maybe blow it off with some compressed air, same thing. We'll just set that there for now. And we're getting there. We're getting down to the cords now, which should all be on the floor. So we'll pull those out. It's probably going to be a bunch of spaghetti, but try to take all these cords. We're just gonna line them all up for right now. Looks like she's got a really long cord here going for something. That was probably her phone cord. And then her charger cord. Power adapter. Another cord. Do the same thing with all of them. Let's see. Really trying to keep everybody's cords together. That's the point of this, so that when you get over there and you're setting them up at their cubicle, you're not missing cords to hook something up. You actually probably have extra cords, but better too many than not enough. And I've got several boxes of cords of various lengths so that we can, you know, for example, if you've got somebody like Mackenzie who's moving from a desk where she's using a 10-foot long cord to get to her phone, and into a cubicle, she'll probably only need a 3-foot cord. So we want to try to, as we're doing the setups over at the new office, use cords of a more appropriate length than this big long thing here, which probably didn't even fit all on the camera. And it's still running from all that dust in the computer too. There's her DVI cord. Display port cord, the cord that goes between the computer and the battery backup, the UPS, so that the computer knows when the power goes out and it knows to shut itself down if it needs to. And the mouse. And then you always want to do another quick check under there, shine under there with your flashlight, make sure you're not missing anything, any cords, any AC adapters, anything else, any whatever in the world that is, a button. She can take care of that herself. But so once you got all the cords, start at one end. Just kind of try to gather up all the ends. And I know before we've talked about this already. We talked about bundling each cord individually. But I think that this is going to be faster. She's got quite a few cords here. have everything. Oh, there's the cord from that space heater getting tangled up in. Take that space heater and pitch it in the dumpster as you're walking out the door. Maybe we can sell them all on Craigslist. But I'm going to take these cords. And we're going to just try to coil them up as neatly as we can. This one's going to be tough because she's got a lot of stuff. This will keep all of her cords together. Hopefully keep them from getting too much more tangled up. Going out. Let's try to catch those, bundle those all up. Once we have everything bundled, see, I'm failing at my demonstration video already because I didn't bring any zip ties. Let's pause this. No, you know what? Yeah, no, I'll get some zip ties. Be right back. Because then we can just change the memory card for the putting it back together. So when you guys are actually doing this move, I've already prepared a bunch of supplies, zip ties, rubber bands, all that kind of stuff. There's a bunch of that in the conference room, cans of compressed air already in the conference room. So, you know, just grab what you need. I asked Kelly to order us some extra bags of zip ties so I don't use up all of the operation supplies. But just throw a few zip ties around it. Keep it bundled up. I'll just use two for now because that shows you the gist of what I'm trying to accomplish here. Keeps all the cables together. And then if you wanted to, put a piece of blue tape around it, you know, so you know who these cords belong to. Put them in her car. Drive to the new office. And then when you get to the new office, you can cut those zip ties. Unravel those just as they were coiled up, and you'd be ready to start plugging in her computer. So let's go ahead and stop it, and we'll change the memory card. Okay, part two. So here we are over at the new office. This will be Katie's. Pretend this is Katie's new cubicle. Isn't it beautiful? What I've done is I unraveled the cords and I just sort of draped them over the side there so I can just start picking off cords as I need them, and also so they you know, have a chance to straighten out. All her equipment safely transported over. Here you go. So, let's see. Again, assuming that we're going to have a hole in the middle of the desks over at the new office, we should be able to pull that out. And we can just sort of start lining up roughly how things should line up. And we know the computer's gonna go back there, and the monitors are gonna go pretty much somewhere where she can see them. Keyboard. Put the little feet down. Feed the cord to the base of the monitor. Drop it down through the hole. Then let's see. What's the next thing? mouse. Same thing. Down through the base of the monitor. Drop it down through the hole. Get her UPS. Set that underneath. There should be power outlets on the sides of each cubicle. Every cubicle will have its own power outlets. At least two, four, in some cases. I think a couple of cubicles might even have as many as six. It doesn't matter which one you plug it into. Just, you know, wherever is conveniently close so you don't have cords running all over the place tripping people up. So let's put that there. There it is, coming back on. We could actually, if we wanted to, start feeding these cables back up now. There's the mouse and the keyboard cable. This is where it's going to be helpful for you guys that are working with a partner to have somebody above the desk grabbing the cables as you're pushing them back up. And, I don't know if you can grab this for me. All right. So, all right. There's those two. That's good enough. Now they won't fall back down. So, we want to get her monitor cables now and do something similar. Let's see, that's her phone charger. Display port, cable, the DVI cable. And we're going to need two power cables. They're the ones at the bottom. There's a power cable. Another power cable. While we're at it, let's just grab the power cable for the computer, too. Sure to forget that I just set it and go looking for it later. Monitors, same thing. Flipping forward, laying flat. Grab a power cable, feed it through, plug it in. Monitor cables. Now, at this point, they're pretty much interchangeable. All of these monitors should have both a display port, DVI, VGA connectors on them. You might need to do some fine tuning to select which monitor is using which cable. The ones that are using display port in particular, sometimes you have to press the button on the front of the monitor and tell it to use display port. If that comes up during this, I'll show you how to change that. The other ones, it should auto-detect. So, tighten that in there. Now, with the left monitor, again, it's going to depend on how the desks are laid out, the size of the monitors, a whole bunch of other variables, but we could actually just feed that right behind the computer, push it down behind the desk a little ways. Let's get these two for our mouse and keyboard. Those over here. The power cable for that monitor. Drop it down. And where did the USB cable for that monitor go? One. should have two long USB cables. Here's the other one. Doesn't matter which we use. I think a lot of people don't even realize these monitors have USB ports on the side. Just run it behind the computer, drop it down, push it through the hole, plug it in. So now this monitor is ready to go. We can stand it up, pull it out of the way a little bit, feed some of this excess cable down through those holes. You don't need this. Nobody wants to see a bunch of cable all over the desk. As you get into position, you can kind of just feed a little more of that cable down behind. So let's see, what do we have left? Power cable for the computer. Same thing. Let's push that down through that hole. Just go ahead and let it fall. Bring it around. I'm just going to try to get all these lined up for where they're going to go. DisplayPort cable. Here's the other monitor cables. Take the second monitor, lay it flat, watch those cords. Power end down through the hole. Feed it through. Plug it in. Get our DisplayPort cable. Drop it down. Feed it through. Plug it in. The DisplayPort cable's got a button on it rather than thumb screws, and it should usually snap. You should feel a snap or hear a click when you get it seated in there. Those cables are kind of finicky. Straight up and tell you guys, you probably have some problems, some issues with the DisplayPort cable. Let's see. Let's get these guys a little out of the way so we can keep getting to those cables. What do we still got? We got the USB cable that connects the computer to the power supply, the UPS. So same thing here. Computer end stays up. UPS end, feed it down through, so again, keeping all the cords close to each other. Network cord. This would be the time when you would select an appropriate length network cord for where the distance between the computer and the outlets are. So in this case, we really wouldn't use a cord this long. You know, you're just going to wind up having to coil it up through a zip tie around it or whatever. But we're going to use it for this demonstration. But like I said, I've got plenty of various lengths of network cords, so we can find the appropriate length one when we get over there. Same thing. Push it down. And now see, I'm going to be pushing down an 8-foot long cord. Let's see, what else have we got? So everything else here looks like it's for the phone. There's her cell phone charger cord, power cord. Now let's just talk about this for the phones again. There's going to be one cord and one power brick for each desk phone. Now at the new office, I'm not going to use these. So set them up in my office. On the backs of the phones, you will flip a switch where this says how they get their power. Right now it's set to DC. It's probably going to blur out moving it that close. There it goes. But when we get to the new office, on all the phones, flip it to PoE, power over Ethernet. And then you will only need to plug in one cord for that phone. And that would be the network cord, because the computer, the phone, will get its power straight over the network. So let's get rid of those, make these go away. And let's finish the computer. Stealing your supplies, Kim. Rubber band. Take all these cords. Look at it again. Does it look like we have everything? Not yet. What are we missing? The DisplayPort cable. Let's just crawl under here. Find that. Push it up. That one's big enough that it should catch on the lip. But again, it's helpful if you have a partner to grab it. Okay. So, now let's just look at these cables again. We've got a network connection, USB for the keyboard, the mouse, the UPS, and on hers, the hub on that first monitor, power supply. So this looks like everything. So take a rubber band, zip tie, whatever, twist tie. I usually use rubber bands because they're easy to cut later if you need to cut them. And we're just gonna sort of bundle all these cables together. Make it so that they don't fall down behind the desk or anything. Or, you know, wrap it around 3-4 times. However many times until it's reasonably tight. So, then on the back of the computer, we're going to make sure to plug everything in. Now it's pretty much foolproof, although whenever somebody tells me that something's foolproof, I always say never underestimate the ingenuity of fools. So, should be pretty easy though for you guys. I usually plug in the DisplayPort cable first. Feels nice and tight there. Sometimes this one, if it's loose, you're not going to have a solid connection. The monitor's not going to come on. So DisplayPort first, DVI, tighten these thumb screws. You don't want to over-tighten them, but, reasonably tight. One thing to watch out for is if those little studs. Actually, let's pull this out again just to show you that. Sometimes when you pull these thumb screws out, the stud that they screw into will actually pull out as well, because that stud is just screwed into the video card. So it shouldn't be a problem for us because all the same cords are going with the same people's computers. But, if the cords were to get switched up for some reason, you'd want to just make sure that, you retrieve that little stud. It would usually get stuck right here on the end. Just retrieve that stud and screw it back into the back of the video card. Let's go ahead and get this guy nice and tight. That rubber band right and didn't do it too tight, you should be able to just pull these cords through a little bit to whatever length you need them to be. I It doesn't matter which port you plug it into. Should be about 6 ports on the back of each of these computers. The power cord. So there you have it. Everything plugged into the back of the computer. Nice and neat. No cords, sloppy cords hanging all over the place. And then what you can do is just work the computer back into its corner. Feed those cords down through. And if you've done it like this, chances are you won't even need to use any split loom, conduit, wire ties, anything else. Just that rubber band should hold everything nice and neat. Now, monitors, you can slide these into place because we're done with everything that needed to be done at the top of the desk. A lot of them you can adjust the height and whatnot. You know, I usually try to, you know, just line them up so they're reasonably next to each other. Grab, if you got a lot of extra cable for the mouse or the keyboard, you know, the person's not going to use their keyboard out here. It's just going to make it fall off the desk. So some of this extra cable, you can push that down through that hole. And twist ties, wire ties, you can take some of that extra cable. You could even put conduit on it if you really wanted to, if you had a whole lot of cable. But for just 3 or 4 cables, I usually just throw a couple wire ties around it. Keep it neat, keep it organized. How are we doing on time? On that video?
2 minutes.
How much?
2 minutes left.
2 minutes left?
10.
Oh, 10 minutes. Okay, cool. Should be able to finish it in 10. So then take your little cover, put that around the cables, pop that back down. Now from the top, everything looks good. Keyboard's here. What else does she have? Let's give her a mouse pad. Give her a wrist rest. Nice to see people using these things. They're good for good ergonomics. Nobody wants carpal tunnel syndrome, believe me. So, let's see, let's do the phone since we're up here too. With the phones, ridiculously long cable, but let's just drop that down behind. I don't know if Katie's right-handed, left-handed, I don't even remember. See, her phone was on the other side on the other desk. Well, it'll be here for now, just to give you the idea. Some people, if they're around, you might want to ask them, hey, what side do you want the phone on? Personally, I always like it on the left side. Answer the phone, and I can still move the mouse with my right hand, but some people like it different ways. So, plug this on the back of the phone, plug it into the jack that says LAN, local area network. There's 2 jacks, don't plug it into the wrong one, it won't work. But just plug it into the jack that says LAN, flip that around. So nice, only having 1 cord. Of course, for her, we've got this headset too, so to get our AC adapter for the headset. Let's see. Let's drop that down here. The headsets, if you get to that point, I think there's only a few people that have them. Should be a color-coded yellow. Plug it into that for the AC. The other ones you probably won't have to unplug. Push the phone back, push the cables down, nice and neat. I usually just push the headset all the way back against the wall. That way you can feed all these extra cables down through there. And for everything on top of the desk, that's it. If you want to plug her, if you want to be nice, plug your cell phone charger or whatever this cord was. Plug that back into the front of the computer. And we could even route that through the hole under the monitor and bring it out right there. So now she can set her cell phone right there, plug it in, charge it, listen to MP3s, whatever it is she does with her phone. Now, under the desk is where everything that we have left to do is under here. It looks like spaghetti. So, under here, let's see. Boy, Katie's gonna need a new UPS here. Good thing I got a bunch of new ones. Look at how the screen is flickering on that thing. All these old ones, they're all starting to fail. Hopefully this one will get her through the move. But I do have spares. So, on the back of each UPS, there's outlets marked battery surge and noise protection, and outlets only marked surge and noise protection. Now, if you were plugging in a calculator, desk lamp, anything like that, you could plug those into this surge and noise protection only. For your computer and your monitors, let's see. I guess for her, we can even do her headset. So if the power should go out and she's talking to somebody on her headset, she only has four devices total, the headset, the computer, and the two monitors. So let's, anything that needs to have power in the event of a power outage, though, you want to make sure to plug that into the side that includes a battery. But for anything else, calculators and whatnot, just plug it into the other side. And it's similarly marked on the cyber power UPSs. So since she does, since we know she doesn't have any calculators or anything like that, every cord here is either for the computer or for the monitors. So we'll plug all those in to the right side. Then we got this UPS, the USB connector here. It's important to plug that in so the computer knows if the power goes out and it'll shut itself down safely so you won't lose any files. Or typically it'll go into hibernate mode, standby. There will be two network jacks on each cubicle. Offices have more, between four and six jacks per office. It doesn't matter which one you plug stuff into. They'll all be wired exactly the same. So you want to plug one in for the phone and one for the computer. And unless the person has extra printers or anything like that, you know, there's only going to be two per user. So now the only other thing we've got is all this mess of cords here. And we're just trying to clean that up as neat as we can with zip ties, wire ties, conduit. It's a bit tough to work under here sometimes. Let's see. That's the cord going for the light. We'll just ignore that for now. You could actually feed all of them through the conduit if you wanted to. I'm not sure if the cubicles at the new office are going to have lights. I guess we'll find out when they get finished being put together. But the split loom conduit, you just sort of open it up on one side, start to wrap it around the cable, and then push it around and up. And this is a pretty short piece, so it's not going to get everything. But it'll get some stuff. Again, I'm hoping to have a bunch more for you guys at the new office. I bought like six rolls of it, but turns out we're going to need some of it to do the server room and a few other places around the office, so I'm not sure how much I'll have left. But that's all there is for that. And then, if you really want to get fancy, this is still pretty messy underneath the here. So let's see, do I have any wire ties handy? Oh, here's one. Let's see if there's any more over here. So, and remember, this is a lot more wires than you guys will have to deal with, because we're using those two network wires that were much, much longer than they actually needed to be. You know, I got network wire, you know, going all the way over there. But, you know, by choosing wires of the appropriate length, it'll make this a lot easier. So We'll just sort of take this wire, and I know we're running out of time on the camera too, so I'm not going to do a very good demonstration, but just sort of bundle it up, get it off the floor, make it so it's not a trip hazard. It's the last thing you want is for Katie to be using her computer and accidentally get her foot caught on a cord and pull the plug out, or trip herself and end up in the hospital. You don't want that. So, and again, just anywhere where it seems like there's a lot of loose cable laying around, and I've only got one way too short wire tie left, so I think that's going to be the end of this demonstration. This is obviously still much more messy than I would prefer, but using appropriate length cables, you know, you should be able to make this a lot more manageable, and then just sort of take everything, loop it up, bundle the cables together, get them off the floor. Like, I could throw a wire tie around here, I could throw another one, you know, I could get this stuff all together, etc. But I think since we're almost out of time on the camera, this demonstration is going to have to end. We'll just bring it right back up here real quick, and you can see her desk set up nice and neat. There's her phone. It would be on at the new office since it would be getting power through the network cable. And let's see. Actually, I am going to have to put in a second memory card because there's one more thing that I'm going to need to show you. So let me stop this for now and put in another memory card on the camera. Okay, here's the last thing I wanted to show you. Okay, so the computer's back up, powered up, everything powered up. We got lucky this time, and the monitors are in the correct place. You can see moving it off the left edge, the right edge of the leftmost monitor, and immediately shows up on the left edge of the rightmost monitor. Now, on some people that have, you know, three monitors or more, you know, this could be a little tricky. Like I said, I just happened to get lucky. But if you boot it back up and the monitors are in the wrong place, right click on any empty area of the desktop, choose the leftmost option, says personalize, and then that'll open this appearance and personalization panel, and you would choose display and then adjust resolution. And this gives you the option of, you know, say you got the right monitor on the left side, the left monitor on the right side, you don't want to get back under there and start messing with your cords. Just go up here, hit identify. Okay, there's monitor number two, there's monitor number one, and you just drag them on this field so that they match the correct locations. So, like, sensors are already right, but if I were to mess them up here, let's do one and two, and then hit apply, and now you can see what's happening when I move the mouse off the left edge of the leftmost monitor. It comes up over there on the right side of the rightmost monitor. So obviously that's pretty messed up. It would be tough for her to work that way. So again, hit identify. There's a big two, there's a big one. We just drag them into the right place. I know not everybody knows how to do that, so that's why I wanted to include it in this demo. Then you hit apply. They look okay, everything's in the right place. Hit okay again, and just close that out. You could, as you're doing these setups, you could open the person's email, make sure that in the bottom right-hand corner, see, it's still booting up here. In the bottom right-hand corner of the main Outlook window, it should say connected, and that makes sure that they'll be able to get their email. And the only other thing is hit the start menu, go to control panel, network and sharing center, then underneath where it says connections, like in this case it's calling it local area connection 2, it might call it, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it doesn't matter the number. But there's only going to be one local area connection. Click on that, and on this window that opens up on all of the computers where it says speed, it should say 1.0 Gbps, 1.0 gigabit per second. So that means it's operating, it means it's connected to the network at full speed. If you see any other number in there, for example, you see 100 megabits per second, that would mean it would be operating at 1/10 of the speed that it should be operating at. So, you know, that's obviously, that would be an issue, and that can usually be caused by a bad network cord. So in that case, you would want to get in there and take out that network cord and just make sure that, you know, when the user's computer connects to the network, that they are connected at the full 1 gigabit per second. And that's it. You're done with the setup of this user's workstation. Unless they're there and ready to start working, you could go and just log them off. And that would be it. Thanks.